Though the tears may fall, my song will rise, my song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise, my song will rise to you. Very good morning, beloved. I greet you in the wonderful, unfailing name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Beloved, on behalf of Rogers Memorial and Fleurhof Congregational Church, I bid you a warm welcome to our online service. Today is the fourth Sunday of Advent, and today we will deal with the joy of the Lord. So we're going to light a candle also of joy. And we trust that God will bless you as you observe and also learn from God during the time of Advent. May God bless you as you listen to His word today. Let's unite in prayer.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Let us pray. This morning's prayer is a prayer for Christmas joy. Lord, as we enter the Christmas season, we want to take time to thank you for sending your Son to be born as a baby and to become our Savior, so that He can bring peace into the hearts of those who believe, and joy to those that find their hope in Him. Lord, we know that only in Him is true peace and lasting joy to be found. And as we sing the Christmas carols and choruses this Christmas season, we pray that true joy would come into the world and that many would find their peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Gathering of the people, sing, O Church of God, shout aloud, all of God's people, be glad and rejoice with all your heart. The Lord, the King of all the earth, is with you. Is responsive, and the congregation will say, and so we cry, Lord Jesus, we await your return. Amen. Lighting of the candle, the scripture for this session is recorded in Psalm 146, verses 5 to 10, and it reads as follows. Blessed are those whose help is in the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God. He is the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them. He remains faithful forever. He upholds the cause of the oppressed and gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets prisoners free, and the Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the foreigner and sustains the fatherless and the widow. But He frustrates the ways of the wicked. The Lord reigns forever. Beloved, we follow our program. We light the fourth candle of Advent, the first candle, the candle of hope, the second candle is the candle of peace, the third candle
We are lighting now the candle of love, and the fourth candle is the candle of joy. We light the fourth candle of Advent, the candle of joy. We remember the great joy that we have in Jesus. And we long for the day Jesus will return, when there will be no death or mourning or crying or pain, and the whole world will be at peace. We light the candle as a reminder that as Jesus came to bind up the brokenhearted, to comfort those who mourn and provide for those who grieve, so we are called to bring comfort, care and joy to those around us. Is response of congregation, and the congregation will respond. Light a candle bright and tall for the joy this season brings. Joy like fountains brimming full through our world, now let it ring. Shine within our hearts today. Oh, come, O joy, to us we pray. Amen. Beloved, our scripture reading this morning is recorded in Nehemiah 8 verse 10, and it reads as follows. Nehemiah said, "Go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is sacred to our Lord. Do not grieve. For the joy of the Lord is your strength." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Though the tears may fall, my song will rise, my song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise to you. While there's breath in my lungs, I will praise you, Lord. In the dead of night, I'll lift my eyes to you. Though the waters rise, I'll lift my eyes to you. While there's hope in this heart, I will praise you, Lord. The joy of
beloved in the Lord, in the short summary, the story of Ezra and Nehemiah is the story of God's people coming home after 70 years in exile. And the purpose of them coming also is to rebuild Jerusalem. Because they return home, the city was rebuilt, the temple was restored, and the stage was set for the eventual arrival of the Messiah. But the question needs to be asked, beloved, why did God invite His people to come home? And why does God keep making a way for His people to come home today? Why would the love of God is demonstrated for such a bunch of stubborn, unrepentant, and disobedient people like us today, and increase their sin and our sin even more? Why does God do it? Only because He loves us, beloved. The joy of the Lord is our strength, is brought to fullness when we accept His provision of righteousness by grace that reunites us so that we can enjoy His divine presence. The joy of the Lord is my strength, beloved, is a familiar line. There are numerous songs based on it. We use it to encourage ourselves and others. But what does it really mean? Where do we go and get it from? What is the joy of the Lord? What does the joy of the Lord do to provide strength? What does the strength we're talking about, where does it come from? The joy of the Lord is basically, primarily, speaking to our relationship with God. The term joy of the Lord is my strength is found in Nehemiah 8 verse 10. And as we said, this after God's children came back to the promised land. They were listening to the law being read, were overcome with condemnation and were weeping. The scripture reads, then Nehemiah, the governor, Ezra, the priest and teacher of the law, and the Levites who were instructing the people, said to them all, this day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep. For all the people had been weeping as they listened to the words of the Lord. Nehemiah said, go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Beloved, we all know the situation. As a nation, to them it seemed that God had deserted them, because God had allowed the enemies to conquer them. The city was destroyed. The walls of Jerusalem was also destroyed. Even the gate was burned down to the ground. And you may think this morning, or feel for that matter, that your Jerusalem is gone. Yes, you may feel some challenges is conquering you and defeating you. Yes, you may feel, my beloved brother and sister, you are out, down and out. Yes, you may feel that you are all by yourself. You do not understand what's going on. Even God has deserted you. You may be at a place where you question the existence of God. You may be at a place and find yourself there. Sometimes you brought it on yourself, and I brought it on myself, for the feeling and the emotions we go through today. Your life may feel to you that it has been destroyed. There is nothing left. Your life is in turmoil. Your marriage is over. You are unemployed. You are facing medical challenges. You are having issues with your family, or rather, you have relationship issues this morning. It seems that your life is over. There is nothing left to live for. And so the Israelites had the same feeling, beloved in the Lord. They felt helpless and hopeless. God had taken away that blessing of being His favorite people. But it doesn't mean if we face challenges that God does not love us. Sometimes, yes, we pay for our rebellion against God. We can be very rebellious as children of God, disobedient to the voice of God. The Israelites were there. We remember they had all the instruments, music instruments, up in the willow tree. There at the river, they sang the song of Zion. Or rather, they were asked to sing the song of Zion. And they asked, how can we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? Maybe that's where you are. You feel destroyed. There's nothing more to live for. That was the feeling of Israelites when they were taken into exile by various kings and countries. But the time is now there to come and to rebuild. Rebuild their lives and cities and homes. Nehemiah undertook the task. And how can he get it right? Something that was seemed so impossible. The people were devastated. They were discouraged. They were angry. They were confused. According to them, I can even add, maybe they felt they were losers. They were ashamed of themselves. How could we rebuild our city and walls? And then the man of God made a remarkable statement. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is unwavered happiness. His anger lasts for only a moment, but His love is everlasting. That's why He gave His Son Jesus Christ for us as a gift, demonstrating the joy that we have in Christ. God's joy is not based on bad or good performance and then is there and not there. Like our happiness is based on ourselves, how happy we can make ourselves. If we can provide for ourselves, we are happy. We smile and we laugh and we is all happy-go-lucky. But as soon as we face a challenge in life, we can see the happiness is something of the past. That is not joy. The joy of the Lord is your strength. And maybe where you are today, that is exactly what you say. Everything is lost. There is no way out. I find myself in this pit, dark, pitch dark pit. No way to get out of that pit. This is the time the man of God reminded them. They are connected to God. God is the provider, the protector, the healer. And God is our Heavenly Father. Beloved, the joy of the Lord is your strength, and for me, joy is knowing God. Knowing exactly that He is my defender, protector, healer, and the list is endless what He is. Perhaps the time has come that you should reconnect with the Creator of all and the Sustainer of the universe. The people of Israel found themselves grieving, crying their hearts out before God, mourning the sin that got them into that position where God allowed them to pay for their mistakes, to feel and realize that there are consequences for our disobedience to Him. Our disobedience is visible in the way we talk, the way we sit, the way we walk. Our disobedience is very clear, the way we respond even to our fellow brothers and sisters, the way we respond even to our own children, and the children respond to the parents. Our disobedience and our short-lived happiness is displayed in when I lose my job, when I lose my house, when I lose my car, when I lose material things in life. The joy of the Lord is your strength. What is the joy of the Lord? Is that relationship and understanding that God is my provider, my healer, my sustainer. God is my Father, and He takes care of me. The joy of the Lord is unwavered in all circumstances. We are able to say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Christ is the center of God's joy in our lives. He's right at the center of God's joy, beloved. If there is no Jesus, yes, you are right. There cannot be joy. There is happiness, which is short-lived. The joy of God is our strength, because we are able to deal with every given situation. And what is the strength? The strength is that God provides us with is His grace. To each one of us, grace has been given. So we pray God for the glorious grace He has poured out on us who belong to His dear Son, Jesus Christ, Ephesians 1:6. Because we feel connected to God and loved by Him, it gives us the confidence and boldness to approach Him to find grace to help in time of need, Hebrews 4:16. And the grace that He provides us is enough for everything in our lives. My grace, He says, is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. 2 Corinthians 12:9. And this is what the man of God is reminding them of when they hit the lowest point in their lives. Then they heard, you know, the life-given words by the man of God. The joy of the Lord is your strength. What do you consider today to be the joy? Or rather, what do you consider this morning to be your strength? Is it your resources? Who you know? Your connectivity? If there is anything other than God and His joy in your life present today, then your joy you don't find in God through Jesus Christ. The joy of the Lord is your strength, your connectedness to God, the obedience to God, that joy that cannot change, is unchangeable. Because God is a God of love. Let's accept Him as our Savior, Jesus Christ, into our lives. And Christ Himself is the embodiment of the joy of God. Accept Him as your Savior. Let this Advent be something different, whereby you can say, and I can say, the joy of the Lord is my strength. That is why I can continue. Not because I'm loaded, not because I'm connected, not because I have this or don't have that now. It's material things. What Christ offers is something money cannot buy. The joy of the Lord is embodied in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for your word this morning. Father God, as we heard the message of the joy of the Lord is our strength. Lord, as we ask questions, as we raise questions in our lives this morning, Father God, where does our strength come from? How are we going to make it through this day? Lord, as the people wept then when they heard the words of the law, as they stood in reverence, as your word, your message to the people being read, and as they began to understand, Father God, so we too, as we feel sorrow in realization of sin in our lives, as we are weeping this morning because of difficult circumstances, and as we struggle with doubt and insecurities, we cannot find joy within ourselves by our own power. For it comes by and from one source only, our Lord. The joy of the Lord, the joy God has, the joy that God possesses, the joy that God centers around each and every one of us, that Jesus endured the cross for the joy set before Him to have a relationship with us. This morning, as we all go about our day, Father God, may we come into realization that we as Christians, that we have access to God's boundless joy that does not come from any circumstances within ourselves, that does not depend on how strong or spiritual we are, that this joy comes from God alone and the relationship that we have with Him. Thank you. Thank you for the joy which gives us strength through the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Beloved, go in peace as we go and embody God's joy and demonstrate His joy to the rest of the world. And now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. as we go out and be the joy of Christ unto the world. Go in peace and praise the Lord. Amen.